for people to go to minister in Chicago. And I'm going to have that group come up. It's like half of the congregation. But if you guys could come up right here, we want to pray and just hear what God did. So I'll let Jeremiah, the prophet, take it.
Hello. So as you said, we're a team of Biola students. And so we were sent through the Student Missionary Union of our university to go and do a missions trip. And the really cool thing is that we're one of seven different trips that got to go out in different parts of North America. We had trips go to Costa Rica. We had trips go to Panama, Jamaica. We had one that went to Chicago and Houston. Whoa, crazy. So, but it's just really, really cool because you know that the testimony you hear from us, multiply it by seven, and that's how big our God is, and that's how powerful his work was during these 2 weeks that we went out. So we went out on December 26th. And came back on January 6th, and we just got to partner with a local church. But before I get into anything, I'll have us all introduce ourselves. I'm Jeremiah.
I'm Mads.
I'm Aspen.
Allie.
I'm Kira.
I'm Austin.
So, as like I was mentioning, we partnered with a church called Missio Dei in downtown Chicago, and we did a couple of Your Loved events, and so what that looked like is kind of like street art ministry, so those two things put together. So what we did was we wore poster boards, and the front we had beautiful artists make beautiful paintings that said, what are you leaving in 2017 on like a sandwich board, and then the other side said, what are you hoping for in 2018? And so we gave people post-it notes, and they would write what they're leaving in 2017 and what they're taking into 2018 or hoping for in 2018. And we got to say, what's your favorite thing about Chicago? What do you want to see change about Chicago? So what we kind of got to do is hear the hopes and dreams of the people of Chicago and hear what they wanted to see change and be able to validate what they want and be able to pray boldly for what they want. And so it's just a beautiful thing. We have a huge list of 70-ish people that we have their favorite thing about Chicago, what they want to see change about Chicago, and just kind of their life story. So really, really beautiful thing that we got to do in a mixture of a bunch of different things. So that just adds a little context of some direct stories that you'll hear. So.
Okay, so one of the things that we did was we had an immersion night with a ministry called Emmaus Ministries that works with men who are in prostitution. And that was like crazy. Like we went to this one church and we watched a video and like learned about kind of what that looks like in downtown Chicago. And for our immersion night, it was basically just to like walk around on the streets in this area called Boys Town and just pray and like, I don't know, just like listen to the Holy Spirit and how he was inclining us just to pray and to have our hearts break for what breaks his. And so while we were there, I was with Mads and Austin, and we walked around, and it was really cold out. This was like later at night, like 10, and it was just freezing. But we walked around for a while and just saw like a lot of stuff going on around us, but didn't really have any like opportunities to talk to people. And so we walked around for like a long time, and then we ended up going inside somewhere and getting warm and just kind of voicing some like discouragement, I guess, about not being able to have any conversations with people because everyone was in passing and it was just so cold, no one wanted to stay outside. Mm-hmm. And then with our last like 15-20 minutes, we went back out. We were walking up and down, just like thinking, praying, talking a little bit. And then right away we met this guy named Glenn who was like standing on a street corner, like supposedly waiting for a bus. And he came with us. We were like, oh, do you want us to buy you coffee or tea? And he was like, yeah, sure. And he came with us and he just started talking about his life and like talking about his story. And he was just such a cool guy and so open with us. And I was like, wow, this is incredible. Like right after we're talking about how discouraging it was that we didn't get to like have any conversations, it was like God just like put him right there in our way. And I remember asking him like right before we left, because the L was leaving and we had to like run away. and he was like, I asked him what I could pray for him about, and he said for salvation. And I was like, what? Like that's so cool. That's like why we're here. Like that's exactly what we want to hear people say. Like we want to hear that people, like that's like the deepest need of their souls. Like, I don't know, it was just really cool. We got to pray with him. We got to tell him about Missio Dei, and that if he went there, there would be people there that would love him well. And I don't know, it was just really cool to see God just meet our, like, discouragement and our heaviness just right away with encouragement, like, just with a cool, awesome interaction. I don't know, it was just really encouraging.
Hello. Hello. So, Jeremiah mentioned one of our main ministries was just being out on the streets, like starting conversations with people, asking questions, like hearing about their lives. And I think like one of the more impactful conversations I've had was one of our like You Are Loved event days. And we met this guy named George, who, after telling me that we were all art students from LA, he's like, oh, I'm an artist too. And he did stand-up comedy. He's like, that's my art. It was really cool. We asked him like what he wanted to leave behind. And he said like working at a desk job. He got a taste of like doing stand-up for a cruise line. He's like, I want to do like for my for the rest of my life. And we tried to hear about the story, which was really cool. And after a bit of a conversation, we asked like what we could or if we could pray for him. And he said like, no, like I'm all right. There are people like 6 miles south of here that are like freezing to death, starving to death. And like I said, like thanks, man. Like that's like really that's like huge. Is there anything in your life we can pray for? And he said, my brother just got in a car accident. He's gonna be all right, but like if you want to toss one up for him, that'd be great. And like we said, of course. And like I was just struck by his heart. Like I always saw like compassion, empathy. Like feeling moved for another as like a work of like the Spirit, but as like every person bears God's image, like we all have His heart, and I got to see like people that like don't believe what we believe. I got to see like there's a little piece of God's heart in them, and that was honestly incredible. Just to know that like there's like this incredible individuality that like every person possesses, yet like we all share these like little beautiful pieces. Of God's heart, and that totally changed the way I think I saw, like, the human person. That was really impactful for me.
So another thing we did was a New Year's Eve service at Missio Dei, the church that we were working with, and this was kind of something that was on our hearts, like, for months before going to Chicago. And I know that I had, like, a very, like, set image of what it was going to look like in my head planning it. I kind of thought it was going to be this huge thing at the church that we were going to kind of a little bit stress out about planning, but it ended up being a lot different, but in the best way. We had a theme that was Hesed, which is kind of, it's the Hebrew meaning of like God's stubborn refusal to give up on us, and it's almost, it's crazy because it's like His love, but there's no like pure definition for it because it's so like vast and so great. So that was kind of our like whole basis for the night. And Adam, another one of our team members who isn't here, did a lot of the planning and basically planned this whole prayer service. And so when we got there, we thought it was going to be kind of a huge thing, and it ended up turning out to be just a little thing, and not even the main sanctuary, like a different room. And most of it was just members of the church like leadership team that came. But it was really cool to get to serve them and just kind of give them a chance to worship and not necessarily have to like, serve other people through doing that, but they can just focus on their relationship with God in that moment. And it was really special because each of us have like certain gifts that God gave us, and we all got to use them on that night. Like some of us got to do worship, like asking God to paint this really cool canvas with flowers and some pots and stuff representing new life, and we just got to interact with the people of the church, and I could like clearly see each of our gifts being used as a team to kind of form this night and serve other people. And I think it was just a really like cool way to humble myself that like, yes, God, if we had this huge like service, would have been there and been working amazingly, but also in this like little tiny baby service, like He was working just as much, and the Holy Spirit was evident there just as much as He would have been in any other situation. And like it was a cool way to posture our hearts for the new year. We all rang in 2018 standing in a circle holding hands singing the doxology, and I can look back on that and just know that that's how I started my year, and that's an incredible thing. And yeah.
So a couple of prayer requests for the church, and one of the overwhelming requests that we heard from people on the street of like one thing that they really want to see change in 2018 is the segregation in Chicago, and that's just an absolutely huge thing, because we stayed in the churches in the nicer part of town, and people loved it. They said that they never had crime, but if you go just about 10, 15 minute walk down to the next neighborhood, it's crime everywhere, and people being robbed, and people having their car stolen. One of the people we talked to said on Halloween, every single tire on this car was taken off. So it's just, there's like crazy division and segregation, and so people want to see that change. People want to see walls breaking down, and those aren't just Christians, those aren't just the church, but those are the people who are living in it every day, who are witnessing the barriers that are there. So that's one thing you can be praying for, and one thing that also that you can be praying for in Missio Dei, the church that we partnered with, prayer is a huge thing there, and the work of the Holy Spirit is like their main source of life, and they love it, and they pray for it, and that's just a huge theme of their church right now. So something that you guys can be praying for alongside us, we're still praying for them, and for the work of the Holy Spirit to not be stopped, for not to be blocked, or for anything to be in the way of it, for them to be devices and vehicles to deliver the power of the Holy Spirit, for them to be the hands of Jesus that are bringing the work of the Holy Spirit, bringing the kingdom of heaven to earth. So that's just a really, really beautiful thing that they're stepping in. That's the season that they're going through. So those are two major prayer requests.
Let's just pray pray for this city of Chicago, for, pray for Missio Dei. Let's pray. God, I just thank you for this young group of people that love you and want to serve you with their hearts. And I just pray right now that a couple things were challenged. One, that our church would be challenged, that our church would be challenged to ask where the fire has gone. There's so much apathy in Orange County to where we see young people on fire, excited to see the things of God and to see God work. And so many times we just kind of sit back and we say, that's good for them. I just pray that it would be a contagious thing, that we would have eyes to see, ears to hear, have hands to touch and love and serve people, Lord, just as these students did. Lord, we pray for Chicago, that city that is so segregated, needing the gospel. I even think of my own, I think of Moody Bible Institute, Lord, how they are experiencing so much turmoil right now. And Lord, I just pray that you continue to work in and through it. I thank you so much for Missio Dei, a church that I was a part of and I was a member of and I loved, Lord. And I just thank you so much for Josh and Anna, Lord, that they are still serving that church and loving that church well. Bless your city of Chicago, Lord. Bless Costa Mesa in your name. Amen. How about another hand for these guys? Yeah, I just...